Okay, it's 7 o'clock. This is a meeting of the Southwick Board of Health, Thursday, January 20th. Present at the meeting is Sue Braska.
Jean Nelson.
Mackenzie Kane.
Tom Fitzgerald.
Tom Fitzgerald, okay. We're meeting, the meeting's being recorded, hybrid meeting, and public comment. Do we have any public comment that has nothing to do with what we're talking about tonight?
Yes, good evening. This is Erica Rossini. How are you tonight?
I'm fine.
I'm Erica Rossini. I am lot owner of 21 Noble Steed Crossing in Southwick, Massachusetts. I'm on this meeting and asking for a variance. I was wondering if I could present my case.
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, awesome. So if you don't mind, I'm going to share my screen. This will help with my dialogue, if that's okay with you.
We have to all get over there to see the screen.
Oh, you gotta let me.
Are we looking at a plan?
Okay. Yeah, I made a quick presentation to walk you through. Okay. It looks like the host has disabled my screen from sharing.
Okay. Tom, you have to set that up when you set up the meeting. If you didn't put share screen, then that can't happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We do have a plan here. Your plan?
Yeah, we have your plan.
Oh, but I wanted to walk you through my story. I created a presentation.
Okay. Don't forget, the public comments is 10 minutes. Is this a long presentation?
Yes. No, none at all. Just a couple slides to walk you through the story.
Can you verbalize them?
Okay. Yep. No problem. What I'll do right after this meeting also, if you don't mind, I can share my presentation with the board. Is that fair?
Yeah, you can email it. Okay.
No problem.
Okay.
Sure enough. Yeah. So I'm going to walk through the presentation that I created, but verbalizing. So today I'm asking the Southwick Board of Health for a variance to the Board of Health regulation. And what that means is, within the section, to summarize, is currently for the town of Southwick, there is the assessed site. You only have 5 years in order to allow the perk test, right? So in summary, what I'm asking for is the site assessment from a perk test dated from 2006 to be my primary location on my lot. So with that being said, I do understand between the 2006 and only having 5 years. When I purchased this lot, I did purchase the lot with two positive perk tests. One in 2021 with perk results. That 2021 was done in September by Dennis LaCour and approved by Tammy Spencer. The 2006 perk test was very similar, but a very distinct location of my lot. I hope by the drawings you can see that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So from the 2006 perk results, that was also done by Dennis LaCour and with Tom Fitzgerald, which I know we all are very familiar with. So why I'm requesting between the 2021 perk site and the 2006 perk site is the perk site recently done is I'm going to label it like up by my mailbox. So that's going to be over 400 feet away from where the house would be located. We're actually calling this, we put it on our site plans. So just in case in an emergency, I would have to use it in the future, but that is not the primary location. The perk test in 2006 is actually a better design. It's a natural gravity fed site and right off of the house, which is typical for our town. If I was to have to use for the 2021 perk location up by the mailbox, again, being 400 feet away from my dwelling, that would require a significant amount of labor, materials, and also a pump chamber going up a hill. So today, in summary, to make it very quick, I'm requesting this variance to be allowed for the 2006 perk test to be used, and I'm going to do it in the following manner. One, it meets all the Massachusetts Title V regulations, so I'm meeting the state requirement. Number two, no updated codes or regulations have been made after 2006 to say that this perk is obsolete. Number three, the land has not been altered in any way, which I had some beautiful pictures of my lot. It's still a very wooded area. As you can see from the Vining Hill Road to my lot, it's all woods. Also number four, the physical perk location in 2006 is visible as I've walked this lot with various subject matter experts, and it is very visible of where this perk site was located. Excuse me. Number five, it's the preferred location of the subject matter experts just based on the preference of what kind of, what actual system would have to go in. So they also recommended the perk test in 2006. In number six, Tom Fitzgerald has reviewed the proposed septic design. So he does have, he has it in front of him, and he's able to comment on the actual. So what I'm asking for today is just to use the 2006 location, asking for a variance from this board today. And this will allow me to move forward on getting an approval of my septic design, which will then allow me to get a building permit for me and my daughter at this new location.
Okay.
Thank you.
So we will take this under advisement.
Now, how soon do you need a decision?
Oh, sooner would be better. That would be lovely. I would love to start clearing the land. Right. So that would be, I don't want to disturb the land if there's any further questions or if anybody wanted to walk the land or the site to see that the lot hasn't been disrupted. That would be very important. So in the next week, that would be really beautiful news. If that's not obtainable, I'm here to work with you.
Okay. So Erica, have you submitted a variance request in writing?
So this is what I created as a presentation to be able to be my written, as a PowerPoint presentation. If you would like me to put it into, it's only 5 pages long.
See, okay.
Like yeah, five you slides. Could email that to Tom, right? Okay, and that would be considered your written request.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, absolutely. And I just for a little more background of me, I grew up in this town. I'm currently homeless, living on Granado Circle in my parents' basement with my daughter. So when you go back to timing is a beautiful thing to allow me to move forward, to build me and my daughter a home in our hometown.
Okay.
So, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. So we have your contact information. Okay.
And yes, absolutely.
We'll definitely get back to you. Okay.
Thank you for hearing me out. I very much appreciate it.
No problem.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to make motion to accept the minutes from the previous meeting. Mackenzie, did you have a chance
to go the ones that Sue wrote up?
This, yes.
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 On the computer, I think.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. I will second that motion.
All in favor?
Jean Nielsen, aye.
Mackenzie Kane, yes.
Sue Grassi, yes. You know, when I do the minutes, I just say we voted to approve.
The minutes should actually call a roll call vote, specify the members.
Okay, well, if we had the secretary, she could do it properly.
If we had the secretary.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm just trying to fill in.
You did a great job.
I just say, yes. Yeah. I say approved.
Yes.
Great.
Okay. Wait a minute. Any other, Peter, do you have any comments?
He's muted. Not tonight, thank you.
Okay. All right. Health director's report.
No other public comment. Okay. Final inspections at 136 Feeding Hills Road, septic tank only, 4 North Long Yards Road.
Repair?
Yes, it's got a number. Yes, 17 Farron Drive, final inspection. Lot 5, North Vining Road, that's new. Final inspection, 18 Shagbark. Final inspection, 16 Noble Steed, that's new. 18 Noble Steed, that's new. Perk test, soils evaluation at 12 Jared Lane, that's a repair. Also perk test at 194 Granville Road, and it's a typo. That should be 264 Feeding Hills Road, not Granville Road.
Is that 194 the new one that's going up there, or is that a repair?
Must be a new one. I think they have an. I think that's the only one I've done on Granville Road.
194 is new.
Yes, a vacant lot. Yeah, there's just a lot there.
That field.
Yeah. Yes.
What's the soils like? Must be
cold. Yeah, glacial tills, you know. Soils evaluation, 11 Falmouth Drive, that's a repair.
And, 264 was a repair too, right?
Correct. Yes. Also, soils evaluation at 49 Coes Hill Road, repair.
Where's that one?
Opposite the field, about halfway down on the left-hand side, going away from town. Final inspection for a repair of a D-box, 43 Buckingham Drive. Sign-offs, lot 17, which is house number 19, Noble Steed. That's all I have for field work. The final draft of the health director's revised job description was sent out to First Place MHOA for their publication.
Do you want to put that on social media?
Yeah. Do you have the final listing? I know we approved it all.
Yes.
That's it?
Yeah.
The one that we all said good.
Sue's last email.
Great.
The one said great to go.
Good.
Okay. So you're going to social media that.
Yep.
Thank you.
I was also going to do it on our Western Mass Public Health Association website. That's our Western Mass.
Okay. Did you put it on, it's on the town's website?
Yeah, not yet. No, the first thing I wanted to do is get it on MHOA. Yeah.
Okay. And then maybe we can put a little blurb on Channel 15, you know, a condensed version of the job.
Do you want to, Jim Milton does that?
No, it's a guy, his name is Ken Stremsky or
Stomsky.
Oh, okay. Do you have, send some blurb to Ken and ask him to put that on Channel 15, okay?
And I'll do it with Jim Middleton for the town.
And where else you wanted to put it? The Western, what is it?
Western Mass Public Health Association. That's our, it's kind of like the, where the
WMPHA.
Yes, that's the one I've been involved with for many years.
All right.
And I'll send information to, in the County Health Coalition, because they meet on a regular basis.
Okay, get it out to as many places as you can think.
Mm-hmm. You know, absolutely.
Warrant it. Okay.
Absolutely.
For sure.
So you have access to that, right, McKenzie? You have that?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Digital. As long as okay.
That yeah, we great. Decided to finalize.
So. Okay, super. Contact tracing. Since we last got together, there's been some changes at the state level, DPH as well as DESE. And I was on a webinar on Wednesday. DESE and the Department of Public Health met, kind of a joint Zoom meeting.
Can I ask something? Is that owl supposed to be facing you if you're talking?
Doesn't matter. It's the top part, the camera part on top.
So it should be facing Tom when he's talking.
Doesn't matter.
What should be facing him?
It rotates.
It's a
we can. Yeah, we can see all of you clearly.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, Peter.
How do my ears look?
Sure. You all look fantastic.
The right thing to
say. Keeping our distance.
So, and then also this morning, I had a meeting, you know, because they're related, a meeting with our West Springfield component, Gene Galloway, West Springfield director, as well as Mike Thoreau, the director from Agawam.
What is this group called?
Which group?
The group that does our contact tracing.
Well, it's not a group. We have a grant, okay, for two positions for contact tracing, which was the home agency, the host agency is West Springfield and Agawam and Southwick. So three towns have an epi and a nurse that does contact tracing. Unfortunately, because of the amount of contact tracing that's been required, even when it's been diminished a little bit by the numbers of requirements, that you don't have to do everybody in your family, you don't have to do complete families. There's still a lot of cases. So we were going to decide, I think, tonight talked about if they were going to continue. And that was if nothing happened with DESE. If everybody wants to know, it's the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. So there's schools. They are, the state has come out with another proposal to provide antigen test kits for students and families to take home. And that's a proposal that the schools can actually utilize if they wish. I called the superintendent today to find out if they were going to go with that plan or not. Some towns have already opted to go with it. They would get at the end of the month, I believe, by January 31st, they'll be start. They want to know, the state wants to know, and DESE, what towns and either individual towns or large, communities which have a lot of school systems are going to want to opt in or out. Okay, obviously we have a regional school system, so I think that the regional school system is going to have to make a decision fairly soon. I talked to the assistant today and asked what their position was, if they haven't met yet, and I think the school committee is going to have to make a decision. They have to notify us, the Board of Health, when they make a decision which way they want to go.
Are test kits available right now under, if you go covidtest.gov?
There's a, yes, a, yes. Yeah, where they'll, you can get a kit mailed.
Right, four for a family. Yeah, but this goes beyond it. This is going to be the $26 million that were spent by the state. So these kits are going to schools and daycares only, okay?
Yeah, so I think that's actually a really good idea because I tried to get a rapid test for my daughter, and the places that we gave out in hopes of them using a centralized location to distribute them, they kind of took them to themselves and hoarded them for their own personal use of like their businesses and did not distribute them. That's what I found, because I called around, everybody's like, no, we use them for our staff and our employees, like we're not giving them out to the public.
This could hundreds.
So yeah. Who did you, like churches and so
so the people we gave them to aren't,
I don't know if there was like clear, I don't know. I didn't call everywhere, but I'm not going to call people out at all. But generally speaking, it was, I couldn't get one. I know, it's crazy. So if they go home with these kids from school, maybe that'll alleviate some of the hoarding issue. I feel like people are like hoarding them because they're like, I don't know.
So go on that site and order.
Yeah, but it's going to take like 4 weeks for me to get them. So, I'll have them for the future.
Even these tests are going to take a while. Test kits are going to take a while. Nothing's going to be, it's going to be quick.
How come the other ones came so quick? Mm-hmm.
Well, because there was a limited supply, and that was almost a test of how quickly they could get them out, as well as that was for 102 communities in the Commonwealth that were considered lower income. That's why we got it.
And that was through the state?
Correct.
And this is going to be the federal government?
No, it's still the state. Right? The state's purchasing them.
Yeah, the ones you get through the mail are
on the federal government.
So the state's purchasing them, and do the schools will get, and daycares will get them free of charge?
Yes. Yes. They're still working out some of the details with that. But the school, it makes a decision and
they obviously haven't made a decision yet. It's because it's so new. This
just I understand, like, what's there to just decide if they're free and if they can get them.
Well, no, they could continue doing the full testing. They're already doing certain things. The contact tracing will be eliminated for unless there's issues, cluster issues. But it's a whole new process of what they're going to do.
Okay,
so not going to do it like we did before.
So if they get the kits and stuff, then the contact tracing is no go.
Well,
because
the school, the burden on schools and on is going to change. So schools are going to be handing them out, either giving them to the students or sending them home. Then the parents are going to be able to, you know, test their children. Where it goes from there is a little bit up in the air, and how that is going to be reported. Right now, and again, this is so new, it's evolving. It's, you know, there's some questions about where, you know, what happens with the positivity and who's going to be recording that, how that's going to be recorded, who's going to know about it. So there are some issues with it just going home to school, but it's going to decrease the amount of what we've considered contact tracing for schools right now.
So should we just leave it as it is for now?
Well, we don't have any jurisdiction. We don't have any jurisdiction.
They just have to notify us.
Because we're going to talk about whether we were going to stop having West Springfield stop contact tracing for us, correct?
Yeah, no. Yes, there's still a need for contact tracing in certain circumstances, like clusters, for instance, schools. So my recommendation is let's continue contact tracing, especially is because it's paid for by the grant already. And it's still useful if we have clusters or issues with daycares or schools primarily, or any clusters. It could be you know, in an apartment or something like that. But they're getting away from state, getting away from wanting to have the individual contact tracing. Right, so they've already downgraded it, as I mentioned, you know, the end of December, not to have every person in contact with the people.
So we're going to continue doing it. Does anybody know how much grant money we have left?
No, but I'm going to have a meeting with her, Jean and Michael next week. We were discussing today's meeting, not so much what was left over for the grant. There's still money available for the positions. And again, the host agency is West Springfield. I can get that information from Jean.
Okay, can I ask, it's my understanding that once you've tested positive, that you could continue testing positive for a substantial amount of time after.
So right now, if you test positive within 90 days, they will not even retest you.
That's my point. So you have all these kits going out to these households. How many times are they bothering to test? I mean, if you have an individual that's positive, why are you retesting them? Because,
well, you wouldn't. The only time you would serial test is if they're negative, and then they turn positive.
Right.
Once you're positive, then.
And you know that as a medical professional.
Right.
Does the public really know that?
No, they don't.
No.
And I don't know, is it in the package insert?
I don't know.
My physician told me, don't bother testing again because you're positive. It could keep showing up positive for.
It can take actually months for you to start testing again.
Literally months.
Especially with PCR.
Yeah.
Tester, because they're much more sensitive than even.
Yeah. I think it's something the public needs to be aware of is don't bother. If you've got it, stop testing.
I think they were looking at testing children 2 times a week. That was their goal.
Only if they've been negative.
So like right. For surveillance testing to right. See if they.
Yes.
Right.
So Mackenzie, what's the infectious period? 2 days before and how many days?
Oh, I don't know. If you ask the CDC, then yeah. I don't know.
Because they're telling you to go back to work?
It's.
Well, they tell you to go back to work even if you're positive, if you're asymptomatic. So,
yeah.
In no time period? No specified.
I think it's 5 days.
0 days.
0 days.
No, 5 days if you're symptomatic.
If you're symptomatic.
You have to take only 5 days off. But you can go back, you can test positive if you're asymptomatic and work.
Just go back to work.
I don't know if that applies to the general public, but it applies to healthcare workers.
That depends if it's vaccinated or not.
If you're asymptomatic and positive, you can go back to work.
And the healthcare 5 days.
Does it matter about vaccinated or not? I thought that was vaccinated, but I mean, things are changing so rapidly.
Because everybody in basic health was mandated to be, so I'm not sure. Mm-hmm.
There's too many variables.
They don't know. They don't know.
Changing.
It's doing the best.
Well, the other issue, I actually put this, I questioned when I was listening to the DESE yesterday, that are they going to be sending, are they going to be showing people how to do these tests properly at home for parents?
Well, maybe they'll have a site go online. I would hope so that they,
you know, or schools would have some, maybe a little.
Are there education. Instructions written in more than one language?
Good question. Good questions.
Usually are in those sort of kits, but who knows.
But at least a visual demonstration would be helpful. Mm. You know, because, you know, watching somebody do the tests like that we had, the ones that came through from the state, if, you know, you've watched somebody do it, then it's pretty, pretty straightforward.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the board's pleasure just to continue as is with the nurse and the epi, and I'll, as soon as I hear anything from the superintendent about what their decision is, again, you're probably going to have to go to the school, you know, school committee, and make and get a, you know, an answer to how they want to proceed with it.
Cool.
I think Carl had sent me, giving some information on the senior partnership program that I had he had mentioned to us a couple of weeks ago, where people from, there's a program in Springfield that they could come out for, I think they could work up to 26 hours a week. Seniors. We would have the opportunity to interview them, and they would have to be supervised by somebody, and be able to, you know, be able to have, you know, tutelage on what their expectations are, and, you know, on a daily basis. But it's paid for by it wouldn't come out of our budget. So I have a lot of paperwork on that, but it's a job enhancement program for people that because of their age or other factors, haven't been able to get a gainful employment. So if that's something you want to pursue, I know Mr. Steinhardt had asked that we look into this. So
we talked about that last time. Right. Remember, I thought they were seniors from high school.
No, senior citizens. Yeah, but I mean, how much longer is this going to drag on that we don't have a secretary?
Has anybody else applied?
It's getting.
For what?
Where's it posted? Oh, is it? I don't know. I feel like we've talked about
something posted on Channel 15.
I think it was. Stuff going on. But, you know, we don't hire secretarial positions. So it's out of our hands.
Right.
And it's just.
Who hires them?
The select board. So it's like, when?
Oh, brother.
You know, I mean, it's not up to the chairman of the Board of Health to type up minutes. We need some support here.
Luckily, we still have Jessica helping us out, right?
And yes, I saw her today. She's doing the permits, but, you know.
Minutes.
I mean, let's pursue these seniors then. Because it doesn't seem like anybody's advocating on our behalf. So maybe we just have to advocate for ourselves.
Well, select board would be the one getting the grant to pursue the seniors.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, not us.
Okay. Yeah, but we have to request them.
So do you have the paperwork to request it, or how do you request it?
No, I mean, it'd be up to you folks. If you want to, you know, try this out, then we would we would get somebody, I would contact the director, he's at the town, Springfield City Hall, and then they would send applicants.
Yeah, are these people who are just retired and want to like have a side job, or are they?
No, they're not.
Like, is this?
There are people that they want to get back into the gainful employment.
But what's like the eight, like just a 65 plus?
Over 55.
Oh, 55, okay.
Yeah, but if they're, you know, sticking to that 5 hours a week at $15 an hour, $75 a week is not going to bring a lot of
senior citizens
that are looking for gainful employment.
I'm talking about the other program.
What's the other program?
Well, you're talking about 5 hour a week. Okay, this is up to 20 hours
a week. So you would have a secretary up to 20 hours a week then through this grant.
Yeah. So one of the things that spoke to the director that we would just need to have some clear definition of what we want this person to do.
Right.
And then so they would match it. Then they have a pool of people.
Somebody who would administrative work.
Right. Exactly. Okay. You know,
and so, be the secretary for our nurses.
Oh, and then cool.
It would be helping in the office, Kathy.
Okay, cool.
So wait a minute, where is this 20 hours coming from? What grant?
The senior people.
So they're saying 20 hours. Okay, so they could be a secretary for us, help in the office, and help.
Yes.
Be for this nurse.
Our on somebody else's grant hours. Money, not our budget.
Right.
Correct.
Right. Okay, right. That's
same
cool.
With the same with the contact tracing. It's not out of it. Not on our budget either, but it's still being applied to us. And that's distinct from the nursing grant, which is another grant that we're working on. That's a separate thing. I know there's a lot to keep track of, but the addressing the issue of the meeting with the secretarial help at some point. If you want, I could move that along if you're in agreement.
Yes,
Move that along, get somebody over.
Agreement 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, let's see.
Just that would look into it. And I did, and I looked at the parameters, the number of hours, the types of people that we could expect, mm-hmm. where they would come from, how far away they would be, things like that.
Yeah, so I was under the impression that.
I think we just voted that.
So, but I don't think we had all the details then, right, about like the 26 hours. Yeah,
have actually handed out that.
So how many hours is it? 20 or 26?
Up to 20. It doesn't have to be that. It can be up to 20.
So they could be utilized other areas of the town too, other town hall too, right?
I think they have to have
a supervisor, somebody that's going to be available for them. I mean, I think there was one in conservation years ago, correct?
Person yes, that there they was. Had.
So.
All right, and, I think and it's I,
So okay, then I'll get some folks to come over to meet with them and start the ball rolling. The only thing I would say is, I just need to give him at least a blurb on what we're looking for. So that's one of the reasons we hadn't really decided what I didn't know that the last time. What we were looking for. You have to give them kind of a paragraph of what we're looking for. But
all right, so basically we need to make secretarial responsibilities. Yes.
So let's think of something now.
Yeah, like Excel and Word, proficient in Excel and Word, available for Thursday night meetings.
I have time to write this down. Oh, okay. I should write this down too, right?
Have flexible hours and days, because I'm sure you'd want this person to at least shadow you around the office for a little while. Pleasant the phone, answering the phone. So
good communications.
Communications, yeah.
So are we looking to delegate roles and responsibilities what this person is actually going to be doing? Or are we looking for character?
More of a job description for this person. So this, in other words, it's like an employment agency, but they want to match this person with our needs.
Okay.
So it would be a better fit.
So I see. Okay.
So you're just thinking about a general secretary.
Yeah.
You do mailings, you do minutes, you attend the meetings, you work on the budget presentations and
and then eventually have them do the food permits. You know?
Cool. This could be, do you know the longevity of the grant? Like, is it 1 year? Is it 3 years? Is it...
No, it's not that long. Actually, okay. It's kind of the way he described it to me, they think they're paying minimum wage. So
what is minimum wage? Do you know?
I don't know.
I'll look at my paycheck.
Okay. 15.
No, is it that much? It's 50. So the part of the program is they want to move people off the program
to higher paying wages.
So exactly. Yeah. So the better they do and they would be more employable, they would leave. So it kind of.
So are these like older adults who are now entering the workforce and they're older?
Re-entering.
Okay. Yes. Okay. This makes a little bit more sense. Yes. Okay. Yes. Got it.
So that would be okay, but then we'd be in the same boat 4 months after that, and then we'd be in the same boat another 6 months after that, depending on how long the applicant wanted to stay. You know, I mean, how many times can you retrain the person?
You'd want to find somebody local too, if you're going to come to it evening.
Yeah.
Maybe you want someone coming from Springfield.
Mm.
You want to make it easy.
Well, yeah, we want anybody at this point.
It wouldn't even be
6 months. It's better than 6 months without anybody. Yeah. Well, it's not that hard to bring them out of paperwork on it, right?
Okay, I'll put together a job description for.
We can get Jessica back for every year. We have to do the permits.
No, I'm pretty sure Jessica's. You know, I mean,
she's out.
Yeah. She's still out.
Yeah, I saw her today. She was here today.
Favor.
Yeah.
No.
A huge favor.
Yeah. She's
still getting paid, correct?
Yeah. Okay. Nurse grant update. I texted Tammy. She met yesterday with the grant contractor. And they had a grant for all the grantees. There are some requirements, reporting requirements that she has to meet. But since they haven't given us any money, there's been no money exchanged yet, even though we have it. Some of the requirements are moot. Okay, so we still haven't gotten any of the money yet, although it's been promised. I know I've told you that before, but unfortunately, that's the way things are moving, and it's pretty glacial.
So what right is it now, that they want?
This is for a different grant.
Your firstborn child.
This is for the grant for the nurse and half the, and the good, the one positive I saw Mr. Didi, and you asked about the space in the our office. When we hire the nurse, and the other nurse, the other half time would be for the other three towns. The full-time nurse would be stationed here, at least, you know, have an office here. We've moved out. Yes, Joe Didi, thank you, Joe, has got right on it and moved the badging technology and from that was in the other side of our office and put a desk there. So now we got a desk for someone when we hired that nurse. Yeah. So
all right.
The badging is somewhere. We don't know where that went. Just gone. It was just gone. It came in on Monday. It was there. Great. So Joe,
it's right behind my desk.
Oh, sorry. Okay, that's where it went.
I found it.
You found it. So
good. We have a place for the nurse, he or she.
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as we can't hire until that money comes in, and it hasn't.
So when the money comes in, it goes to who?
The town
clerk.
Yes. Okay. Yes. And then we can advertise. Have you seen the job description for the nurse? Have you okayed that, looked at those? Because if not, I can give you a copy of that Tammy had.
Oh yeah, that would be cool. No, I've never seen it.
Make a note of that.
This is something that Tammy had sent out, the nurse.
Well, it might have been a while ago. I mean,
We do have the questions to ask the health director. Questions. We do have that.
Yeah. Okay. I'll get that copy too.
Do you want to look at that one and see if it has to be revised at all?
I mean, I think we all should.
Yeah.
Right. But I would just have a little bit more insight.
Right. Absolutely. But even as important as that is, don't forget this is these are for three towns.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Even though the other one, and it maybe, and I think the thought was that they could help cover each other if they're when you know one's on vacation. So even though the other one's only working half time.
Right.
They would be able to cover, you know, the event that someone's on vacation or ill.
Yeah. So I didn't look though. Does this cover? Will this one posting cover both the full time and the part time position, or do we need a separate one for the full time?
They have to be separate.
They have to be separate.
I'm sure they could be the same wording.
But if there's time hours, right? Yeah, and locations. Yeah, and I think I mentioned to Tammy a previous email that be important if all the towns got together and
kind of okay whatever
they're doing, especially not just the job description, which is really important, but also how they divided the time. Right. I know which the one of the nurses is going to be here, but where the other one is going to be for the half time is
maybe mobile with a laptop.
Right. Well, that was part of that was a thought. Yeah.
Unless those other towns have a place for her.
Him.
Right.
The person.
We're going to have that person cover three towns, right?
Yes.
Maybe the other towns might have a.
You mean the other three towns that have to have.
Yeah. Maybe they'll have areas.
Within their town. Yeah, sure.
Municipal
building. Yeah. Well, that's it. It'd be nice if we can get everybody together and talk about it. But as far as I know, they're really small towns. Hence the need for that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Montgomery and Russell are so tiny here. You know, right. Part-time town halls.
When the money comes in, do you want to set up a meeting with them?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
And do they have any projected timeline of when the money's coming? No.
Okay. 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
No, I just said. No, I mean, it's been like that. Like, it's coming in two, you know, and then 2 weeks goes by, and then 2 weeks go by.
Okay. Do they say what the holdup is?
Just government, COVID, and, you
is
know.
Is it coming from the state or the federal?
That's the state. I wish I had better news for you, but at least we got the desk.
Well, we shan't hold our breath, but that's okay. We got space for a minute here.
Yes, right.
We're moving slowly.
Yeah, this is government. Okay.
Cool.
So the last and probably one of the most important things is the Finance Committee.
No, COVID testing site.
The second. From the last time we spoke, RN Wellness will not do a drive-through. They're no longer doing it. They couldn't accommodate it, so they are no longer a possibility. However, I reached out to Curative in the last couple of weeks. They're the ones that are doing that. They're at Westgate. They can do it. And one of the things we discussed was having a pop-up COVID testing site here, and to kind of reduce the concerns some folks had with having it during the week. They would do it on a Saturday from, for instance, 10 to 2. They would come in, they'd have their own staff. They would use the same place they were going to use before downstairs. And then by appointment only, they would schedule. And then we would see how it works out.
Mm-hmm.
And if it goes great, then we could add more time.
Is this surveillance testing for like asymptomatic people with exposure, or is this symptomatic people?
Be anybody.
Could be anybody. Yeah, they don't. Yeah.
Be anybody who wants it.
Oh,
so yeah, by appointment only. Yeah.
Maybe. So who do they call to make an appointment with?
Excuse me.
Who do they call?
They have a site. Yeah, they have a site. Yeah, they would advertise that.
Okay. right. And we would have to advertise it too, right?
Well, it wouldn't be just for Southwick. It's anybody that can get in there. We can't restrict it. We can't restrict it. So
it's just you luck out if you happen to have symptoms and you're like, where can I get a test? And then this
or place, right? Even the people that need tests that are feeling fine to get back to
work.
To get back to work. Oh, I mean, okay. Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, but then again, if they were sick, they tested positive. They're going to test positive again.
Well, some people are actually sick and they have flu-like symptoms, but they have the flu,
right.
Not COVID. So, you know, some people are concerned about, you know, I have a sore throat or something. Or
so when you say a pop-up site, is it going to be indoors? They're going to be coming.
It would be drive-through. They'd go out and do it, but they'd be stationed downstairs with their computers and stuff.
And it's going to be PCR testing.
Yes. Yes.
What does PCR stand for?
Chain reaction. Polymerase.
Polymer chain reaction.
Where they take a little bit of the RNA and the DNA and they keep amplifying to detect it.
Okay.
It's the most reliable test if we shove it all the way back into your brain.
Yeah,
but recently we just did nasal.
Yeah, really? They went to nasal instead of the nasal pharyngeal.
Yep, good stuff.
Okay.
So, would you like to pursue that again? There's a couple of more logistical issues I have to work out. Security.
Do we need to hire a cop? Because if it's a drive-through,
absolutely. No, we definitely got to definitely have to hire one.
All right, and is the selectman on board with this?
Excuse me. This is a new iteration, but okay. But the principle is the same. We're going to have it here. It's going to be outside. Okay. And it's going to be on a weekend, so we don't have to worry about all the town traffic.
But
other than the people coming. But in other words, there's nothing. Yeah. There's no people coming in to pay the bills and things like that. Okay.
Because people will line up down College Highway to wait in line.
But if it's by appointment.
Yeah, it's going to be by appointment.
So there won't be that much congestion. Okay.
We those are things we don't know what Southwick's going to be like.
Right.
You know.
And who pays for the cop?
Oh, we do. Okay. That's going to come out of us. So that's if you're a go with that, I will continue to pursue it with the other people, basically the same people we had at our last meeting for the RN wellness.
Yeah.
With the exception that we're not doing it during town hall hours, which should be a little more palatable.
Because people have a hard time finding.
Yeah, it's another resource that we can have in town. Yeah. So it's a valid idea for sure.
And find out how much we're going to have to pay an officer per hour.
A lot.
Yes.
Yeah.
And would that come out of our budget or that come over the town? Some general.
I think it'll come out of the.
It'll come out of
the town. At least we'll try.
Is it 4 hours or 6 hours? Do you know the time window?
Six.
Six.
Yeah, and even some of that's flexible. But there's those. 10 to 2, 10 to 4.
Okay.
And, good. You know, in that realm. Yeah. And again, if it could be expanded in terms of, it depends on how many people show up. So, in other words, some of it's like we don't know. We don't know how many people, is this going to draw from the surrounding towns or not and fill up? But some of it's we just have to see what happens and then plan accordingly for the next time, but at least we'll have it set up that we'll kind of assume it's going to be maximized. That's why with the police for parking and security assume that we need that in the full complement of the space downstairs for the people using the computers. So I will continue to pursue that for the next meeting. Hopefully I'll have something before then. I'll have met with Mr. Steinhardt and the other John Westcott's old job, Bob Johnson's, the
kind of the maintenance, the head of maintenance for the building.
Oh yeah,
they have to open up. Yeah, yeah.
So who's the head of maintenance now?
It's not Gary.
If you said the name, I would know it. Yeah. Somebody we know.
Yes.
I don't know.
You would
know
if you
had
a nature. Okay. All right. I'll think about it. You had a DPH meeting.
Did you talk about that one?
A what? Update on DPH.
Yeah, I kind of already talked about that. That was it.
The combine
one. Yeah.
Okay, great.
And oh, actually, in addition to that one, we had another small one in the state that the Catherine Brown said that they are seeing a reduction in the number of cases in Massachusetts. So she says, I have some good news. So we're, we're cautiously optimistic about that.
Number of positives?
Hospitalizations.
It's a positive, like 400
positive trend. This is statewide, so you're going to have pockets that are high, towns that are high.
But our numbers themselves were just...
283?
No, ours was 400.
Yeah.
Well, this is what case count the last 14 days. And so 113.22, that was the last day.
Yeah, those numbers with the antigen tests being... pushed out are going to become less and less accurate as more private tests come into place.
Yep.
And that's one thing about these, that's the pop-up one, those are going to be counted because of those PCR tests that was going to be
right.
Going into Maven.
Okay. And Valerie, let me see what Mondays.
Valerie.
44 cases on Monday alone. 54 on the weekend, 75 active cases, 317 since January 1st.
I knew it was up there.
All right.
Budget.
So my thought is, what Tom had an idea. Tom's idea.
Yeah, didn't I?
Yeah.
You level fund and take some of the nurse money, since we're going to have a grant, and put it toward clerical part-time.
Yeah, don't forget, we can't do anything with that portion of salaries. That we can only work under the Board of Health operations. That's the only thing we can do. The health nurse, the salary, the care, the longevity, we can't touch.
Right.
But we can request, you can ask for it. Right?
Yeah. You can ask if they move it.
Right. But
yeah, let's ask if they move a certain amount to clerical part-time. Because we don't know if this grant thing from the senior partnership is going to work out.
But that's where you would want to go on what form? On form number 2, where it says salaries, you would want to put a part-time Board of Health secretary there. In case the grant, or in case they want to actually hire somebody who wants a full-time job, and then ask for, 10 hours a week. See on page 2, include number of hours per week, rate, and number of weeks.
Yeah, and then we could just explain to them to take it out of the nurse and put it there. So the person now...
This would only be for them... The finance committee to actually approve of Board of Health secretary like Jess. It would have nothing to do with taking grant monies out or anything.
Right.
Eventually, we could move some money into that. But for this budget report, this would just be to request that the town of Southwick hire a Board of Health secretary permanent at 10 hours a week at the going rate of $15.30 an hour.
And then they can, and then if they're wondering where that money's gonna come from,
it's a new position in the town. It's not something that we're going to budget. We're going to ask the finance committee for an employee.
That's for clerical.
For clerk.
Yeah, but we already have money in the budget, so you're going to augment that.
This is the fiscal 23 budget.
Yes.
Fiscal 23, we're going to ask the finance to come put
for more.
No, we're going to ask the finance committee to hire us a secretary.
Okay, but just like when they came to the other meeting, we were talking about the health inspector, how he wanted more money. They were trying to figure out where was that money going to come
right.
from. And if they need to know where that money is going to come from, we can say you can take it from the nurse.
But that's not.
I don't get it.
Yeah, I'm confused.
Okay,
because we already have a line item.
Okay,
so we can keep the line item the same or add it.
Right.
Add it.
Right.
Add to it.
We have an existing line item for clerical.
Right.
Okay. So we're going to ask for a full-time employee as a Board of Health secretary for 20 hours a week. Right. So they're going to take that line item that we have here under clerical with a budget of $4,094 and make that a full-time or a 20-hour a week position at whatever 20 hours a week times $15 an hour is. You know what I mean?
No.
Isn't that the same thing as requested by the department? Whatever that amount is on the very end, the very last column.
We can't touch anything up here.
You're requesting it. You can't touch.
We can't touch anything up here. We can't touch anything up here.
Well, we can request.
You can request it. Yeah. Isn't that what we're going to the finance committee for? To request.
To move things around.
Yeah. And or.
Okay.
Increase the salary.
Okay.
I mean.
We're confused.
P.S. Didn't we ask for $70,000 for health inspector salary and it's the 62?
Well,
I don't even know
because that was the old one.
Okay.
This is a fiscal 22 budget you're looking at.
Right.
What we're doing is going for a fiscal 23 budget. Okay.
I don't even know what we're honestly talking about.
That's July 1, wasn't it? For July 1.
It's July 1. Okay. So just black this whole thing out. Because they're going to give you whatever increases that they would normally do. It's like a 2% increase for all these jobs. That's the number they're going to put in there. So what we need to do is fill out on page 2 a request for a secretary. And then that, if approved, they will put here in the budget.
Okay, so
it's not what exists now, it's future.
Form two. And how are we going to, we can just fill that out right now.
Yes.
Okay, so how do you want to write this?
Number of hours. How many hours do you want? 10 hours?
Yeah, 10 hours. If we can get that other 20 hours.
So put 10 hours, because if, you know, we don't get this senior citizen grant.
But those are for new requests.
Right.
We already have a budget line item. Are we
just
adding to it?
Do we have a secretary? Do we have a secretary?
But we have a line item. But we have a line item.
No,
that's, but then what they do, they can approve this and then they can put the money in there.
That's
or
right.
Whatever.
Right.
This is
asking for a secretary.
Yeah, we'll ask for the secretary.
This is fiscal year 22 budget. This is fiscal year 23 budget. Yeah.
We'll ask for
it's a new position.
Okay.
I don't see it as a new position. We already have one.
I know, but if they want to know where the
we're adding
money.
The we're adding okay. hours to an existing position.
Yeah, why don't we just add hours to an existing?
Well, that's what we're doing.
Because we don't have a secretary.
Well, that's a separate issue.
Yeah,
we're asking for money.
We're asking for a secret. We're asking for a body.
Yeah, but they're not going to give us one. They're just the finance committee. They're going to give us money. They're not going to give us a body.
Huh? They'll give us money for a body.
Exactly.
Right. They'll give us money for a body.
Right.
So that page 2 is we're asking for a body.
the disconnect is between the money and the actual staff. Is that what I'm understanding?
I don't know. Yeah, I think so.
I think so. Okay. Now, so if you want to do it your way, if you want to just say, okay, request, put more money on there, go ahead.
Okay, so we're going to say 10 hours per week at?
It's 15:30 an hour, 15:32 an hour, I think.
Do you want me to look up minimum
wage? Should we just say going rate?
Yeah, sure.
No, that's the current secretarial
rate. Oh, okay. Sorry, I thought it was,
should I say going rate? Because won't they get some kind of cost of living?
It might be a cost of living. But you're going, yeah.
At the going rate.
Yeah.
So we have to put in an amount requested.
Well, 10 hours at
10 times 1530
is $152 a week.
10 is 52 weeks.
1532. Equals.
So Tom.
So this.
Why
this
don't you do it your way too?
8,000.
Why don't we just do it both ways? And okay. Like, what are they going
to go ahead? Put under requested by department. Put under 8,000 there.
Yeah, let's definitely do it both ways.
Because.
Maybe we'll double, maybe we'll
I've been double. Doing budgets for the town for
a gazillion years.
10 years.
All right. So, Jean, on
but
form
two. The difference is we already have a line item.
Okay. June.
We have,
Jean,
we have
so I'm going to say 10 hours per week at 1532. I'm going to request $8,000.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Is it comes out to 8,000 even?
No, I rounded it up.
Oh, okay.
And great. Number of weeks, 52 weeks. Okay.
Got to write that down in pen.
Right. And then, Tom, you can just put 8,000 there and see what they come up with.
3 hours per week.
Maybe so they'll get a 16,000.
Yeah. You're really optimistic.
Right. Somebody here's got to be.
What's the percent increase that you get every year? Do you know?
2.5.
Not even.
Sometimes. I don't know. 2.5 is just
it varies.
Business world.
Usually it's a minimum of 2.
Okay, so
but I know some years we get nothing.
So 15.32 30 cents.
Okay, so
wow.
15.60.
So it comes to 8,100. So we'll say it's going to be
$100 a year.
We'll say 8,200. That's all I'm going
to raise. Yeah. I mean, you can always ask, and
four.
They're going to tell you no anyway.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So we'll just say 8,000.
Okay, so Tom, you can add it to that page number one and submit it on page number two and see what they tell you.
Okay.
Okay, so wait a minute. I don't have to have a page number one here.
Page number one is where we're going to level fund everything. Form number one.
This one's form one.
Perfect.
Okay. So you're just going to level fund everything.
Well, no, because
we have to have the 5% decrease and level fund. You have to look at all three.
You don't have to put in a 5% decrease.
We're not going to do that. We're not going to. But we are going to put in for the health inspector. We're going to put in the 72. What did they up?
It says we're requesting 3 budget columns to be completed.
Okay. Health inspector is a salary. We do nothing with the salary budgeted portion.
I know, but they have a blank there for us.
And that's where we're just talking about salary for budgeted person right now.
We do nothing with that top portion.
Well, we. Aren't we're doing something with the top portion. We're just talking about.
No, well, that's why. Okay. You can do it, but that's not how these budgets are done.
Okay, so look at, so under operations, 28.
What the heck did you guys do? Does anybody do this every year?
I do this every year for three different boards and committees. That's part of my job that I work.
So Jean, so under education, over by requested by department, I'm just gonna put in 2,800.
No, you're going to the middle column under level funded.
And I put in 2,800.
2,800.
Okay. And then immunization clinics, 556.
That's level funded, yeah.
And then 1,800 for consultants.
Yeah.
And 225 for minor equipment.
Right.
And 922, just weird, 922 for supplies.
Yeah. And it comes up to the 6303. Okay.
Can I just ask a question? Because I don't actually know how this works. So when we asked for their request and they said, yes, we'll give it, it's just not reflected in that number because why?
Because it doesn't exist yet.
Okay.
Okay. So this is fiscal 22. What we're doing, these numbers are fiscal 22. What we're doing is asking for fiscal 23, which starts in July 1st.
Okay.
You're not a finance person.
So what do I do? What do I do on the blanks, the lines by the salary? What do I put there? Because they have lines that they want us to fill in.
Nothing. I don't even know why they have them on this form, because we are not supposed to touch anything up there. The only way we can get something added to that top portion is by adding something on page 2, which you did. Okay?
And then do we already know that we have the 70? How much was it for the inspector? Was it 70,000 or was it 70?
70, I think it was 70 even.
Yeah.
70 even.
Yeah. Because don't forget, you're looking at the fiscal year 22. And
I don't understand that though, because we are in 2022. So when does it kick in?
July 1st.
July 1st.
It's 22 to 23.
Yeah. The okay. town's calendar starts July 1st.
Right. I understand the fiscal calendar, but when we offer this job, we have the money available to offer them. That's all I care about, right? Yes.
Okay. If they approve it for the 23 budget. So in July, if they approve it, then in July, we can go for a 10-hour a week.
You know, so I'm going to write something up.
And just say,
it's fine. You know what?
It's fine.
I'll check with Terry Mishra. Our finance, finance person.
Right.
As long as we have the 70 grand to offer.
Because I can type something up to attach to this to say the 70, that we want 70,000 for the new person when the new person starts. Right. And we want maybe 1,000 in the nurse salary.
But
just to explain.
What happens if the person, new person starts before fiscal year 23?
Which person?
Tom part 2.
That's what I'm asking. This week we're posting a job for 70 right. grand, but do we have that 70 grand?
It's been
committed. They'll be taking part of it out of here.
Okay.
Okay.
And then they get the rest from.
Then they're going to have to pay the person in arrears, essentially.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm good with that. As long as the person gets paid, I'm good with it.
Right.
So should we write something up explaining that? What's the 70,000 for the inspector? And then for the clerical, this clerical person, which would fall under part-time clerical, they can take some money out of the nurse to hire our person. Okay, I will.
You know, I think Tom had a great idea.
What?
Talk over, you know what the board wants. You can talk over this over with Terry Mish
and then see how he advises.
Well, that's
you.
Yeah, he's our
because he's
liaison
the
for the finance.
Are we all just supposed to know how to do this?
Well, they have directions.
I mean, that's what they do. That's their board. But, that's all they do. That's
no, I mean, like, as a board of health member, am I supposed to know how to do this?
No, they have directions here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
They're not very explicit, obviously. Otherwise, we wouldn't be in such a conundrum.
See, if you look at guidelines form number one, that each department, board, committee, and commission submit an operational budget. So they're only asking for operational.
Well, except for they're looking for new staff in form two.
That's why you put it in form two, not in form one.
Right.
That's why you just don't add 8,000 in form one.
Right. Salaries
that's
will
for new staff.
Salaries will be filled in by accounting.
The difference is we're not asking for new staff. We're asking for additional money for existing line item staff.
Oh, I don't have that. Oh,
that's the point.
Okay.
We're getting at.
We don't have that person.
We have
so
a line
it has
item.
To be a new person.
We have the line item.
But we don't have the person.
We didn't have the person when someone quit.
Money's
still sitting there, whether the person's there or not. The
just
money's
ask
still
Terry.
There.
Yeah,
so just
ask Terry.
How he wants
ask
to do Terry. It. Tell him how do we indicate that we want 70,000 in the salaries?
I'll check with Terry and that.
And we want the nurse to be cut back to 1,000.
Okay.
And do we need something in writing indicating that when we go to the meeting?
Oh, we have to present. Is that a meeting?
Yes.
Yeah.
We have 5 minutes.
Yeah. They usually schedule them in February.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But they printed these in December and sent them last week.
Yeah. Okay.
So no board.
No,
is
right.
Ready
exactly. Yes. They did.
Because it has to be voted on at a board, at a meeting.
And I think almost every time they schedule a meeting, it's a weekend I work. It's usually on a Saturday. Yeah. And it's a weekend.
On Saturday?
Yes. Yeah. It's always Saturday.
It's always Saturday. And it's always on a weekend that I work.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
this is fun.
I'm going to make a motion
fine.
For okay. level funding the operational budget. And then have Tom work with Mr. Mish, our financial liaison, on the position, a 10-hour position for a replacement secretary. For the one that resigned. In the event that this grant thing doesn't work.
Okay.
That's my motion.
I want to add to that too.
You can't add to my motion. It's my motion.
Okay. Well, then I'm not going to second it. So
no, you can amend it.
I can amend the motion?
Yes, you can amend
it. Wait, do we have to vote to amend the motion?
Well,
I'm going to abstain from this vote because I don't even know what it means. And I'm not putting my name to a vote of what I don't know. I won't.
Go ahead,
Sue. So
you can amend my motion.
And to also to talk about this new position, to talk about getting a secretary, but also to find out where do we put the 70,000 for the health inspector.
To ensure that the 70,000
yes,
salary that was offered
I have that,
is
no,
in
that. I will.
Okay, that's
I would go over with Terry on that.
That's my motion.
Yeah. You go. Okay, make a motion to work on the 2022-23 budget request.
No, it's only 23. It's only fiscal year 23.
Okay, fiscal.
Fiscal year 23.
Budget request to level fund the operations budget and to work with Mr. Mish, our financial liaison, to ensure, well, first of all, to ensure that the 70,000 for the health inspector be in the budget and to
request a replacement secretary at 10 hours a week for for a full-time position at, you know, at standard secretarial pay.
Yes, I'm never going to read this. I'll be calling you to say it again.
You're going to listen to it on Zoom. Just bring up the meeting and you can hear the whole thing again. Okay? So that's my motion.
I second that motion. All in favor?
She Milton, aye.
Sue Braska, aye.
And Pezzagane, yes.
Okay. Agreed.
Okay?
Yep. Now what?
So Tom, you understand?
You'll be reading that, you'll never understand.
Tom, do you understand all that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, there's one more thing. Jessica's been going doing the permits, and I'm going to give this to Sue here. This permit for the body art, we have a tattooing person and a retail place. So we have to adjust.
This is just an example.
An example. Yeah, this is an example. So obviously the name of the business would go here to operate, or this needs to be changed to, and how do you want that wording to, you know what I mean?
So we got to make two of them, right?
One right, here, one right. It's hereby granted a 2021 permit.
2023. To
22, okay, 22 permit, and then one's for the body art.
Well, to operate, it is to operate. One is okay. It is to operate.
Okay. To operate an body art establishment. Oh, then they would just take it right from the application. And then the other one will be to operate a body art practitioner's, or
to
not operate.
To
what? A body art practitioner's.
Is hereby granted.
I don't even know what we're talking about.
Granted to the tattoo person. Body art, just a, this is the first time that they ever, we've had one. So they're just putting together a new form.
Yeah, but didn't we decide that they all go through the state and not through the county?
No, that's not, that was not
that
true.
That was not true.
No,
okay.
No. Right. No. Tanning salons, okay. But there's one thing that they threw back to us, but we have model regulations that were taken from the state, and that's been approved and stuff. We just never used it because no one ever came in. Ever.
Yeah, so this is like a microblading.
So she's just going,
yes, yes, and some medical stuff too.
Medical stuff?
Well, I perform medical duties. Tattooing.
Oh,
how do I say it?
Areolas.
Yes,
perform
exactly.
The duties
yes.
To perform. The duties
that's
of
cool, actually.
Yeah.
A body
yeah.
art.
And she's worked in Westfield. I mean, she's
the cool. Duties yeah. of
okay. Like that. Okay. Okay. All right. I mean, then do we want to talk about Erica Rosini?
Oh.
Her
okay, it says here that a soil suitability site assessment results are valid for a period of 5 years from the date of site assessment. Validity of a soil suitability assessment after expiration shall be reviewed on an individual basis.
Now that's Southwick regulations.
This is Southwick.
That's not
Southwick.
Correct.
Okay.
This is
verification of the assessment results, the precise location of the assessment test, and any change in the topography or drainage at or near the assessment sites shall be provided to the Board of Health. The Board of Health at any time may require additional percolation tests or soil evaluation tests to be performed for confirmation of a previous test at the expense of the owner. It doesn't talk about, if we grant this, these have to be really revamped. These regulations.
Yeah,
the Board of Health may grant a variance to the application of these regulations when, in its opinion, the enforcement thereof would do manifest injustice the application has demonstrated that every request for a variance shall be made in writing and shall state the specific variance sought and the reasons therefore.
Right.
The writing shall contain all the information. A public hearing may be held for affected abutters at the discretion of the board. Any grant or denial of a variance shall be in writing and shall contain a brief. So we may do a variance.
Well, Tom showed us the plans, and Tom was the one that actually did
witness the pertinence.
What's your professional opinion?
And his professional opinion is that it's fine.
Yeah.
So I have to trust Tom.
Yeah,
I would be more than happy to grant the variance for that.
Me too. Should we just vote on it?
Yes, we can vote on it.
Because seriously, there's no reason to make
a public hearing may be held.
Right.
And there's no affected abutters.
Right.
So close proximity.
Right. In your professional opinion as a PERC tester and not as a board member, you would say that it's appropriate.
Well, Tom witnessed the PERC.
Yeah, he was there when it was done.
Okay,
yeah,
got it.
Yeah, he witnessed it as a health director.
And,
oh, I see. Okay.
And then they also had two new tests, even though they were a few hundred feet apart. The soils, there's been numerous tests in that area. It's not like it's a tough area in terms of getting PERC tests. They've gotten several PERC tests, so it's not surprising that they.
So why was the second one done though?
Because the first one expired. Oh, so when they did the second one, they didn't do it in the same location. They did it 300 feet apart of where the original one was.
And you have to understand that when people are selling their property, if they're selling it, they don't necessarily know where the person is going to be building the house. Some people build it real close to the road. Some people, if it's a big lot, they're going to build. So they're going, I don't know, but we just need to get a new PERC test. So that's why they put it out in front of the road in retrospect.
Oh, so she just bought this property in 2021, not in 2006?
Right. Yes. She just bought this.
I see. I thought it was she's had this property.
Oh, no.
So they just did the PERC test close to the road because it's probably convenient and they didn't know she was going to build so far back.
Right.
They did the PERC test when she's still on the property. So she should have came to the board before they did that second PERC test to see if she could.
No, I didn't know she owned it then. I didn't know.
They may have re-perked it for her to buy it.
I think the seller did because it had expired.
Yeah.
Right. So they need to re-perk it to put it for
sale. Satisfy this, but now we're coming back and say, well, the best, you know, you actually heard her explanation was actually pretty good. It does make more sense in terms of the siting of the system.
Okay. Yeah. So does anybody have any objections if we vote on it now so we can give her an answer?
No, not at all.
Okay.
However, the application, because she does, will be that presentation that she sends to you via email. And then you will reply in kind on a written reply. Okay.
We can even send
because I think that's what Sue just read in regulations.
We can send her a letter.
Yes.
So
okay.
Okay, so I'll make a motion to approve the variance on the basis of the written request being adequate to Tom's approval.
Okay, that sounds good. I'll second that motion.
So
it's still writing adequate
request. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out how to spell it.
A-D-E-Q-U-A.
And who knows, these minutes may not be anything like we're saying stuff.
Well, maybe someday when we get a secretary, they'll.
So we're just doing the best we can.
You know?
Is that a new secretary or an existing secretary?
No, that's a fiscal 23 secretary.
It's a $16,000 secretary.
So we're making a motion based on the fact that she sends all the paperwork and everything.
Yeah, approve a variance based on an appropriate written approval. Tom's.
Appropriate written request.
Request, sorry. Yep.
Right. Which is the presentation.
Correct.
Okay. Will that work for you, Tom?
And then sure Tom does. Will send.
I'll send a letter.
Send a letter.
Yeah. Okay. So everybody in favor of this motion?
McKenzie I seconded Kane. It. So.
So you're good. Mackenzie Kane, yes.
Gene Nilsson, yes.
Sue, yes.
Great. Hey.
So the witness is just going to say everybody approves it.
Great. Lovely.
So the regulations I have We started revising about 20 years ago.
That was the latest, yes.
So,
oh brother.
Hey, you're in this for 3 years. I mean,
I should.
You're up for re-election for this? Where are you at?
Yeah. Well, you want to work on a revision of those?
Well, we started revising them 20 years ago.
Okay.
But those are the ones that were.
Are we done here?
Yeah.
So,
is there Peter? Are you there? Or did you fall asleep?
Still awake.
What do you have for, you have any questions?
I'm trying to think back. I think I had something from the beginning. Oh yes, the so contact tracing. I just want to make sure that I'm getting this right. So you guys are going to keep doing it as you were, or is it just going to be schools and possible clusters?
That's how
Or yes. That is how you were doing it.
The latest requirements from the grant are de-emphasizing the personal contact tracing and emphasizing schools, clusters, and either daycare centers, elderly housing, things like that when there's multiple people involved.
Okay. For the testing site that you were talking about, is that just going to be a one-day thing, or is that going to be on multiple Saturdays?
That depends.
It's going to start as a one-day
thing. Yeah, we're going to
try
it as a pop-up. And if it goes well, then we would probably want to continue it.
Oh. Okay.
So that's, in other words, it's to be continued. We'll see how it goes.
All right. And last thing, I stepped away from my computer for a minute, so I might have missed this if you did talk about it. Do you have an updated COVID count?
No, not really.
No, okay. We have a site that you could look at.
I'm looking at that now.
The state site. We can give you a.
I have something that I received on Monday. So this is the last 14 days, and the date on this is the 13th. So it's probably going to come out again tomorrow.
Yeah.
Total case count in the last 14 days is 283.
And Peter, I can give you the link for that directly.
No, I've seen that one. I didn't know if you had the last 7 days, but yeah, that I forgot that was the 13th, so you wouldn't have it today anyway.
Yeah, so that's all I have.
Okay, that's all I have. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, 8:30. Jean Nielsen makes a motion to adjourn.
Okay, well, we're going to try to meet in 2 weeks at 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
Oh, at 6 o'clock, we're going to change it to 6?
Well, no, we've been trying to change it to 6 for the past two meetings, but Tom's so used to putting down 7.
No.
So are you okay with 6?
I'm okay with 6.
Yeah.
Everybody okay with 6?
Yeah, because he's like 8:30. Yeah.
I hear you. Yeah. I'm okay. Yeah, I just forgot.
It's real early. So we'll try it again.
Wrap it up.
Oh yeah.
Yes. We gotta
close
a motion
the meeting.
To adjourn.
I second that motion.
I second.
Oh great.
All in favor,
Mackenzie King.
Okay, so Tom, will you see?